guys, today I have this nice workbench, but if we flick the lever, it's a 3x3 trapdoor. So it's actually a trapdoor with a center block that pops up, as you can see. And I made it together with Purple Dragon Nuke, I think is his complete name, but I'm really bad with names, so sorry if I said it wrong. But definitely, you should definitely check him out in the description, he has some cool stuff. And yeah, let's take a look at the wiring for this one. And here it is. As you can see, it's pretty small. It's only 8x9x2, making 144 blocks, I believe. And yeah, we did some quite interesting wiring, in my opinion at least, because it doesn't have your regular 3x3 starter, but it actually, it uses a dual edge here, which fires the double extender on both edges. So basically, when you flick the lever, it will first fire the double extender. At almost the same time, this dust will turn on, but it won't do anything as these pistons already extended before that. This repeater will try to turn on as well, but it's locked by this delay, so we have a little bit of a ABBA here, because if I now flick the lever, it will turn off after 3 ticks, but for turning on it needs to wait 3 ticks more through this delay. So after 6 ticks this will turn on, and that's exactly when the double extender pulls back this piston. So it's just in time for this block to extend in here, just before this dust will power it permanently. And then afterwards it will, after 1 tick, retract this piston, and then after 2 more ticks retract this piston, and then fire the double extender again. So we used some ABBAs, ABBAs, whatever, for the correct timings, and that was actually the hardest part. And yeah, I think it's pretty cool how the system works. I don't think you could have easily done this with the regular 3x3 starter, so it's always cool to see some less usual circuits, in my opinion. So yeah, let's go to the tutorial. So as usual, you will first need to find the place you want to build it, then decide on where you want to have the input and where crafting table should be. So this is the site we will have the input with ours. So at that site we also have the redstone block right there. Then on this site we will have the double extender and block storage and that stuff. Oops. Okay, goddammit. This is facing up there, and our block storage. So yeah, we can place the crafting table right there. Then on this side we only have one piston, and on this side we have the other three. So then to start off we will have not that, but this. Like so. Then we will have one block and a repeater on 3. And yeah, I have no idea what to say, as you can just see what I'm building again as usual. Oh, I lost my direction there. Statics. And I believe you can actually have a block there, to make it a little bit cheaper again. Only one redstone does cheaper, but it's something. Then we will have our double extender, or the circuit that fires the double extender, at least here. Or whatever. We will have some redstone here, basically. So this is our dual edge, and We need a non-solid block right here. That's kind of a downfall from this design, but for most blocks you would use, there's probably a staircase version of it, and otherwise it's not seamless anyway, so I don't think it's a big deal personally. Then our torches. And now our double extender circuit itself. Like so. Yeah, I believe this is it. Yeah, so this should actually be it done. Let's give it a try. Okay, so yeah, that's all. Then you can just fill in your other wall blocks. And special thanks to Theo, as he made this design a little bit cheaper. So because of him, you now don't need any comparators in this design, and before you needed two of them, so that helps. And yeah, some other things, it's a tiny bit faster. Yeah. So that's cool. So I guess that's all for this video, and see you all later. Bye.